It was exactly a year ago when President Rodrigo Duterte first placed the National Capital Region under lockdown, triggering similar quarantine restrictions in different areas across the country in the following days. And while the lockdown was key to fighting this pandemic, it led to the worst economic recession the country has ever seen since World War II. Warren De Guzman breaks down the data in this special report.
In March 2020, Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte placed the entire National Capital Region under strict quarantine to arrest the spread of COVID-19 across the archipelago. But what was supposed to be a temporary sacrifice of economic activity to stop the COVID-19 outbreak in the Philippines has now turned into the world's longest-running lockdown. The damage was staggering. The Philippine economy suffered its worst year since World War II, contracting 9.5%. The second quarter, when the lockdown was strictest, saw Philippine gross domestic product shrink by 16.9%.
Our quarantine restrictions reduced household spending by 801 billion pesos in 2020, or an average of around 2.2 billion pesos per day. The fall in consumption translates into a total income loss for families of around 1.04 trillion pesos in 2020, or an average of around 2.8 billion pesos per day.
Before the lockdown, the Philippines was an emerging economic tiger amongst major countries of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, ahead of Malaysia, Indonesia, Thailand, and Singapore in terms of GDP growth in 2019. After the lockdown, the Philippines is now behind the field. Countries with better COVID-19 pandemic responses, including Vietnam, have done much better. Vietnam even managed to grow 4.5% in the fourth quarter. The second quarter of 2020 also produced some of the worst labor statistics for the Philippines ever. The tight lockdown resulted in a labor force participation rate of 55.7% in April 2020, the lowest in the country's labor market history. National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa says any form of lockdown, even the granular lockdowns now implemented to avoid a repeat of 2020's blanket quarantines, could produce the same results.
Yung data natin, I think noong October 2020, kung saan may mga lockdowns tayo na localized, ito rin yung isa sa mga quarters kung saan mababa yung ating labor force participation.
Even amid the drastic increase in Filipinos giving up completely on looking for work, the unemployment rate spiked to its highest levels since 2005. As of January 2021, there are 4 million unemployed Filipinos. Foreign direct investment inflows to the Philippines also nosedived in 2020. From $8.7 billion in 2019, FDI fell nearly 25% to $6.5 billion last year. 2020 was also the third straight year FDI inflows have gone down for the Philippines after it peaked at a record high of over $10 billion in 2017. This wasn't unique to the Philippines, but there are other factors which could turn even more foreign investors away. Inflation in the Philippines, for instance, is higher compared with the other major ASEAN economies, driven in part by the impact of social distancing and health protocols on commuting, making transport more expensive. Economists are already worried inflation might choke a key economic engine in the Philippines, consumer spending. Another economist notes Philippine inflation has not peaked yet.
We're coming from a very low base from last year. Any and all uptick in terms of the index at this point in time will only print upwards. So likely that's going to be around May.
Central Bank Governor Benjamin Jokno, however, says the other driver of inflation in the Philippines is food, and the upward pressures on food are temporary, such as bad weather in agricultural zones and the African swine fever outbreak.
We have demonstrated over the years that we are very good in our inflation targeting. As I said, the inflation expectations remain well anchored. We expect inflation to be within at least the upper bound this year, and then to about 2.7 or below 3% next year. And in fact, our forecast for 2023 to 2024, if I remember right, is that we will still be within the 2 to 4% growth targets.
The other factor that could turn off investors is COVID-19. Data show that while the lockdown was able to slow COVID spread, especially early on when the quarantines were very strict, COVID cases still spiked and are in fact spiking again right now. The Duterte economic managers, however, say tighter lockdowns are not the answer moving forward. Instead, they are banking on vaccination. The numbers don't lie. The promised effect of the lockdowns on the economy came true, with growth and employment down sharply. The promised impact of the lockdowns on the pandemic also happened, but any headway in slowing the spread of COVID in the Philippines has now been lost. COVID-19 is still here, and it may be worse than ever. Warren de Guzman, ABS-CBN News.